Becky Lynch can tell you, just like Charlotte Flair will, or anybody who's ever held a championship in WWE, it's almost easier to win the title than it is to retain it. Becky now finds herself as a target.
Yeah, target to Charlotte Flair.
Right to the knee, and Becky Lynch comes out firing. Champion's advantage tonight for Becky Lynch. Charlotte must pin her or submit her to win the championships. Count out, disqualifications don't help.
Look at this, Becky Lynch coming out of the gate 100 miles an hour. Well scouted to this point. Taking the legs out from the queen.
And Charlotte's in trouble early.
Becky Lynch knows she needs to come out here hot because Charlotte Flair is so successful in these big match situations.
And we saw what Charlotte did this past week on SmackDown when Becky Lynch came out to the ring, debuted this poster of herself at Super Showdown, and Charlotte took offense.
Well, funny, because there's actually a mural that was done here in Melbourne from a street artist that said, "You keep me off your posters, your morning shows, and your magazines while the people put me on their walls." It was an unbelievable mural that was done.
Well, to your earlier point, Renee, about the big stage, the grandest stage. Here we are with over 70,000 people here in Melbourne Cricket Ground. This is where Charlotte Flair shines brightest.
Oh my God! Charlotte landing hard on the back of her neck. And this has been a vicious early assault by the SmackDown Women's Champion.
Listen, you may not agree with this side of Becky Lynch that she showed recently, but you can't argue with the results.
Into the post, shoulder first, Charlotte. And you can hear her.
Becky has been relentless. She has been ruthless, and that's why the Irish Last Kicker is your reigning SmackDown Women's Champion.
And Becky into the ring, gonna look to put Charlotte away quickly in the cover and a kick out. Again, Corey, it goes back as we take another look, and watch this. Becky just dragging Charlotte out of the ring. And it goes back to this chip, this major chip that Becky has on her shoulder.
Listen, I can understand the frustration that Becky Lynch has expressed. She felt as though she spent too long of her career in the shadow of Charlotte Flair. And the queen casts a gigantic shadow. It's a very realistic situation. But whatever Becky has changed in her mentality has worked.
Problem is, though, is that Charlotte Flair is a seven-time women's champion. Becky's held the title twice. Charlotte has earned everything that she's had here in WWE.
I don't disagree with that for one second, but who walked to the ring with the title tonight, Cole? Becky Lynch, you gotta count that for something.
Charlotte slides through, cover, stacks her up, and a kick out at two, and a big chop by Charlotte. Becky, though,
beautiful. Armbar. Armbar applied.
And Charlotte's in trouble. Center of the ring. Is she going to tap? Is she going to tap to Becky Lynch here tonight at Super Showdown?
How great would it be for Becky Lynch's ego to know that she submitted the queen in short order on this stage?
Add a little fuel to her fire.
And Charlotte, though, manages to survive at least at that point, but again,
right back into
the arm bar.
And notice how Becky Lynch elevating her hips, putting all the added pressure, and now pulling at the fingers of Charlotte Flair.
Oh, and doing everything she can to try to get Charlotte to tap out, trying to break the fingers of Charlotte Flair.
Charlotte is in a great deal of jeopardy early on in this matchup. Look at the way Becky has Charlotte's wrist bent back, pressure on the elbow, on the shoulder.
And Charlotte trying to make it back to a vertical base and somehow break the armbar using her power here. And that buys Charlotte a little bit of time. Back to her feet. And Charlotte, nice suplex drop. Becky on the back of her neck.
Folded Lynch right in half. Incredibly painful. This is what Becky had to avoid, allowing the queen to have time to recover.
We saw Becky come out here flying on all cylinders, and it just wasn't enough to get it done right off the bat. We'll see what she has left in her tank.
And again, take another look at this move by Charlotte. And again, Renee, it goes back to the point that Becky feels disrespected. She feels like she has to prove everything when she goes out in the ring each night.
I see such a different look in Becky Lynch's eyes, a different demeanor all around. I've never seen this side of her.
Queen stops, look at this.
Charlotte, though, with a great counter, and now Becky's in trouble.
I can assure you, of all people in this stadium right now, the one person who wasn't underestimating Charlotte Flair is Becky Lynch. Lynch knows what the queen is capable of, and she can go deep into a match.
Well, Becky doesn't feel like she was just wronged by Charlotte Flair. She feels like she's been wronged by everybody. WWE Universe, WWE.
And Becky uses the second rope to her advantage, delivers a kick to Charlotte, and now looking for the Charlotte fighting out.
Both of these ladies so familiar with one another. It's almost as if they know what the other's gonna do before they even try.
Great throw by Charlotte. Becky caught up now in the ropes, but can Charlotte somehow get back into this as we take a look at what happened earlier on?
This is a great counter. This is an example of Charlotte Flair being able to think on her feet, knew what was coming, and inflicted some great damage to the knee of Becky Lynch.
Becky Lynch again with a great counter as Charlotte goes face first into the second turnbuckle.
Both these women just looking to inflict so much pain on
Forearm.
Cover off that battering ram. Kick out at 2.5 by Charlotte.
See a look of frustration already on Becky Lynch's face.
You talk about how well these women know each other. You think they've got to dig deep into their arsenal to try to throw the other one off.
Yeah, it was a great strategy Becky Lynch had coming out of the gate hot, trying to shut the queen down before it got too deep. Now Becky's going to have to reach deep into her arsenal and figure out a plan B.
Yeah, both of these women, of course, came up as part of what was called the Four Horsewomen, along with Sasha Banks and Bayley. And look at Braps going with the figure four, and great block by Becky Lynch. And a big boot by Charlotte into the cover for the championship. Hooks the leg and forces Becky to kick it too.
I can't imagine what it will do to Becky Lynch's ego if Charlotte Flair walks out of Melbourne, Australia with that SmackDown.
You're absolutely right, Renee. I agree with you. I mean, here you've got Becky Lynch, for whatever reason, has forsaken her former best friend.
Boom!
As we take another look at the big-time boot from Charlotte. Becky Lynch has thrown this relationship in her life away.
Now look at Becky. Becky caught her. Becky caught her, almost stole in there.
In order to be champion, to lose it this quickly could be catastrophic to her ego.
Yeah, but let's switch the tables, Corey. What if Charlotte doesn't leave here with the championship?
Charlotte Flair only knows one way to live, and that's on top, to be the best.
See the viciousness and the disdain these women have for one another as they throw these big right hands.
Egging each other on.
Being a women's champion has defined Charlotte Flair. It's in her blood, it's in her DNA, it's all she knows how to be.
Yeah, but Becky Lynch is a long road back to the championship. Headbutt by Becky. Charlotte explodes off the ropes with a spear. Turned her inside out for the championship. Cover by Charlotte, almost had her 2.5.
Just that quick, Becky's championship reign almost ended.
Charlotte Flair looks absolutely devastated. She thought she had it in the bag there.
Now frustrated as well. Watch this spear turn Becky inside out. Almost brought Charlotte the SmackDown Women's title to make her an 8-time Women's Champion.
Both of these women exhausted, given so much in the opening moments of this matchup.
The jet lag of traveling halfway around the world, brutal hatred that's been brewing for months.
Well, so much has been made, of course, of the first ever women's all-pay-per-view event, Evolution, coming at the end of October, October 28th.
These two women here,
two of the trailblazers that get us to that moment in October. Charlotte, top rope, looking for the moonsault! Becky got the knees up! Becky rolls through, shoulders down. Is it enough to put Charlotte away? Kick out at 2. So many near falls in this match.
Enziguri.
Oh, Charlotte's out.
But Becky's on spaghetti legs herself. Is she going to be able to capitalize?
Both these women punishing each other in this match for the SmackDown Women's title. Becky going to climb up to the top rope. Now she is going to go. From the high red district, missed with a leg drop. Charlotte moved out of the way. Both high risk maneuvers missed by Charlotte and Becky. Now Charlotte trying to build momentum. Does she have enough?
Charlotte steps over. There it is. Boston Crab is applied.
Center of the ring, Boston Crab. Becky nowhere to go. If she taps here, Charlotte wins the championship. Becky trying to drag herself to the bottom rope and force a break here.
Charlotte's trying her best to sit down to get the depth needed to make that hold complete, but.
Yeah, but how wise by the champion, too. Becky not only got to the ropes, but she rolled out of the ring to get out of harm's way.
I think Becky might be using her champion's advantage here and taking a hike.
Now, Charlotte is not going to let Becky leave that way as she drives her ribs first into the barricade. Now, Becky with a boot to the shoulder. Spear again by Charlotte. There's for the second time in the match.
No way Becky survives two spears. No way.
Yeah, but can Charlotte capitalize? Can she somehow get into the cover here? No. She's going to go for the figure four leg lock. And if Charlotte can bridge here, if she can bridge into the figure eight, we may have a new champion. Becky's struggling. Charlotte trying to bridge. Can't quite get it locked in.
Becky's too far from the ropes.
Becky trying to stretch and make it to the bottom rope. Charlotte looking to bridge into the figure eight here.
Wait. Becky's got a hold of her championship.
Becky with a championship. And she saves her title via disqualification.
Here is your winner by disqualification, Charlotte Flair.
Bottom line here is Becky knew she was done for. When Charlotte bridged in the figure eight, Becky was going to tap out. She used the title to her advantage and got herself disqualified.
It was absolutely a desperate maneuver by the champion, but it's a little easier to look at a paycheck being a little light when you still have your championship around your waist.
And Charlotte is, she's not done. She's had enough. Charlotte felt like she was seconds away from being crowned the SmackDown Women's Champion.
And Charlotte very well may have been. But the fact is, Becky Lynch used a wise, albeit questionable tactic.
Oh, my God, what a collision!
Lynch just flattened the queen.
And Becky's not done yet.
Becky Lynch is on an absolute terror path right now.
It's over, Becky. You hear referee Mike Kiel. It's over, but not for Becky Lynch.
Tempers have just gotten out of control from both of these women, champion and challenger included.
The change in Becky Lynch's demeanor over the past number of months is incredible. Just being around her today, back in the locker room area, to see the change that this woman has gone through since back at SummerSlam, Renee. And you've known Becky for a long time.
I've known Becky Lynch for a very long time, and I'll tell you that she's not going to be celebrating with any friends in the locker room tonight.
Listen, I think Becky Lynch should be the first to admit she's undergone many changes recently, but the one change that counts the most, the only change, is she can now call herself champion. We'll be right back.